सच्चिदानंदन त्रिभुवन कोरेजार चरण वंदन त्रिभुवन कोरेजार चरण वंदन नीलाचले शंख चक्र गदा पद्मधार नादिया नगरे दंड कमंडलुकार नीलाचले शंख चक्र
गदा पद्मधार नदिया नगरे दंड कमंडलुकार
केह बोले पूरवे रावण वधिला गोलकेर वैभव लीला प्रकाश करिला
केहो बोले पूरवे रावण वधिला गोलकेर वैभव लीला प्रकाश करिला
श्री राधार बावे वे गोरावतार हरे कृष्ण नाम गौरा करिला प्रचार
श्री राधार भावे वे गौर अवतार हरे कृष्ण नाम गौर करिला प्रचार
वासुदेव घोष बोले करे जोड़ हार जय गौर से कृष्ण से जगन्नाथ
वासुदेव घोष बोले करी जोड़ हार जय गौर
गौर से कृष्ण से जगन्नाथ
जय गौर से कृष्ण जय जगन्नाथ
वासुदेव घोष बोले करे जोड़ हार जय गौर से कृष्ण से जगन्नाथ
वासुदेव घोष बोले करे जोड़ हार जय गौर से कृष्ण से जगन्नाथ
जय जय जगन्नाथ सच्चिदानंद त्रिभुवन कोर जाय चरणावंदन
जय जय जगन्नाथ
सच्चिदानंद त्रिभुवन
कोर जाय चरणावंदन
हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा राम रामा हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे
हरे रामा
राम रामा हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा राम राम हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे
हरे राम
राम राम हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा राम राम हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम हरे राम, राम राम हरे हरे,
हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
वासुदेव दोष बोले जोरे जोड़हार, श्री गौरा श्री कृष्ण श्री जगन्नाथ।
वासुदेव घोष बोले गोरी जोड़हार, श्री घोष कृष्ण श्री जगन्नाथ।
वासुदेव घोष बोले कोरे जोड़हार, श्री गौर श्री कृष्ण श्री जगन्नाथ।
वासुदेव घोष बोले कोरी जोड़हार, जय घोष कृष्ण श्री जगन्नाथ।
हरे कृष्ण हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
हरे कृष्ण
कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे
हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे।
जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद, जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद।
जय जय श्री चैतन्य चंद्र जय गौर भक्तवृंद।
जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद, जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्तवृंद।
जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद, जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्तवृंद।
जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद, जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्तवृंद।
जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद, जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्तवृंद।
कलयुग पावन हरिनाम संकीर्तन की, अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की, श्री चैतन्य चरितामृत की, श्री प्रभुपाद की। ओम अज्ञानतिमिरांधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकया चक्षुः उन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। नमः ओं विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे, निर्विशेषशून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे, वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च, पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद, श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे, हरे कृष्ण। Where is my books? Hare Krishna, welcome all of you for the Chaitanya Charitamrita 8th chapter of Madhya Leela. Talks between Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Ramananda Rai. Yesterday we began one of the last but one section. I want to say a little more about that topic. You see in this 8.280, he is saying, Ramananda is telling to Mahaprabhu, 8.280. He is saying, Nija guda karya tumara prema aswadana. Anu sange prema maya kaile tribhuvana.
My dear Lord, you have descended in this incarnation of Lord Chaitanya for your own personal reasons. You have come to taste your own spiritual bliss and at the same time यू आर ट्रांसफॉर्मिंग द होल वर्ल्ड बाय स्प्रेडिंग द एक्सटेसी ऑफ लव ऑफ गॉड हेड.
सो हियर वेरी इंटरेस्टिंगली रामानंद राय सिंह टू लॉर्ड चैतन्य महाप्रभु दैट यू हैव कम फॉर टू ट्विन पर्पसेस. वन पर्पस इज यू वॉन्ट टू टेस्ट द डिवोशन ऑफ श्रीमती राधा रानी. So you are Shyam Sundar, but you assume the form of Gauranga Gaur Sundar to taste the bliss of spiritual devotion of Srimati Radharani for Krishna. But at the same time, you also want to spread that ecstasy for the benefit of other living beings. So in our life also, sometimes we have some intention of, you know, doing one service which we like very much. Like somebody may say, I like to dress the deities, or I like to study Bhagavatam. I want to go to some place and study Bhagavatam for years together. So sometimes we have a plan which may benefit only us. It may not benefit others. But here from Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu we can learn from his internal reasons and external reasons. He actually fulfilled both the purposes. His own purpose and the purpose of reaching out the, you know, Krishna consciousness to other living beings. So that is really a sign of good intelligence. If you can do that, janma sardhaka kori kara para upakar. Because one of the three qualities of Vaishnavas is upakarita, which means para upakar. Ishwar ki prati ananyata and sahishnuta. These two, three qualities. Tolerating all adverse situations and going on in bhakti peacefully. And upakarita means being compassionate and merciful to the suffering souls. And Ishwar ki prati ananyata means, you know, to have a undivided devotion service to the Supreme Lord and not diverting our attention to anyone or anything else other than Krishna. So, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, 18 years he stayed in Jagannath Puri and relished the transcendental mellows. And by that he taught us it is important for all preachers to also personally relish the Krishna Katha themselves and experience it. So Prabhupada writes in one place, what is the use of that religion which does not offer you personal religious experience of what it teaches? Like that he says, pratyaksha vagamam dharmyam susukham kartum avyayam. The path of devotion service is actually called pratyakshavagamam dharmyam, which means it's a practically realizable path. Everybody can go through the path of bhakti yoga and come to a point of joyfully practicing it with Krishna in the center. So we not only want to preach, but we also want to relish what we are giving to others also. Sometimes ago, one of the friends was telling me that somebody sent him a WhatsApp message of one very nice Prabhupada's quote, which was half a page or so. And then when he forwarded to some 40-50 devotees, he got a lot of applause from various devotees. Everybody appreciated him for sending that, and you know. And so then one devotee asked him, you know, Prabhu, that day you sent that very nice quote, everybody appreciated you. Can you please little bit explain about that? He said, I never read it, he said. I only forwarded it. You know, he got from somebody and he forwarded it to others. He never read it himself. Which means he didn't relish it, but he acted like a transmitter. From here he got it and he transmitted it. That is not very good. So we also have to receive it, relish it, apply it, then we have to give it also. No? That is very important. So therefore, he is saying that you have descended in this incarnation of Lord Chaitanya for your own personal reason, but you are also transforming the whole world, Ramanandra says.
Aapne aile more karite uddhar, ye be kapata kar tumar, kon avyavahar.
Yeah.
My dear Lord, by your causeless mercy, you have appeared before me to grant me liberation. Now you are playing in a duplicitous way. What is the reason for this behavior?
This is the section I was very keen to elaborate today. The Ramananda is a pure devotee of Krishna. And Krishna is trying to hide himself. It's not that Krishna is going to hide completely. Krishna cannot hide himself from his devotee. He is visible to his devotee very easily. Now, the purer and purer one's devotional service becomes, the easier and easier Krishna will make it for the devotee to get revelations about himself. Like for example, Balram, he had complete revelation of Krishna when Kaliya was subdued by Krishna. Everybody else was weeping, but Balram was fully confident that nothing can, you know, harm Krishna. He was fully confident. He in fact gave confidence to everybody else. In the same manner, Balram is actually Guru Tattva. So, His Holiness Gaur Govind Swami Maharaj, you know, he is a very pure soul. The sannyasi, he has written many wonderful books and spoken many powerful lectures on Krishna Leela, like Mathura Meets Vrindavan. Both Gaur Tattva and Krishna Tattva and Radha Tattva, Maharaj has spoken very elaborately, very nicely lectures. So at one time Maharaj found that many people are going to many outside sources to read and they are not studying Prabhupada's books well. So then he spoke on this topic of how everything is in Prabhupada's books. So very nicely he explained it. He said, you know, if you are going to a ocean and superficially swimming on the surface, you will only get fishes there. But if you go deep, you will get diamonds there. Therefore, ocean is called Ratna Garbha. In the Garbha of the ocean, there is Ratna. But superficially, you will get only fishes. Similarly, if somebody is reading Prabhupada purports only superficially, then they will not be able to get the diamonds, he said. Therefore, one has to systematically study his purports and see from various angles, scrutinizingly study it, Prabhupada said. That was one thing he said. Another thing he said, the Acharya's commentaries are very exhaustive. You know, for 18,000 verses of Bhagavatam, there are so many Sanskrit commentaries, like Jiva Goswami commentary, Sanatana Goswami commentary, Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur commentary. Elaborate commentaries are there. And nobody has time to read all of them. And they are all in Sanskrit. But Prabhupada has made it all available in English for us. And not only he translated them into English, he took the best part of those commentaries and he collected it like a honeybee. A honeybee only collects honey. It doesn't carry the full bush. And then Prabhupada has given. So he wants to give you the taste of that honey. And once you read the whole Bhagavatam of Prabhupada, you become a fixed up devotee. Then Prabhupada recommends you to go to those Acharya's Tika. And then you have your rest of the life, you can leisurely read those Tikas, which are all now getting translated from English to Hindi. Sanskrit to English, Sanskrit to English. They are all getting translated and available now. But why I'm telling you, His Holiness Gaur Govind Maharaj gave firm faith in Prabhupada's books by teaching the whole world that everything is in Prabhupada's books. You only have to study them to appreciate it. So, in this way, you will see that Gaur Govind Maharaj himself is a very exalted soul. He has read several other books and everything, but ultimately he came to this conclusion that although there are many, many books, you can read Ujjwal Nilamani, you can read so many books like that. But ultimately, the essence is there in Prabhupada's books. So, he gave faith to the devotees. In the same manner, because he had that firm faith, same with Parampuja Radha Govind Maharaj, he appreciates Prabhupada's books for, appreciates Prabhupada for presenting very purely. So in this way, you find that as one becomes more and more exalted, Krishna gives them conviction, Krishna gives them revelation of the truth. Recently, I am reading this Shuddha Bhakti Chintamani by His Holiness Shivaram Swami. What a clarity in that book. He has taken from Prabhupada's books and he has elaborated on what Prabhupada is saying and presenting the Siddhanta very, very with great clarity. And his affection for Prabhupada, his firm faith in Prabhupada. And that is giving us faith by reading his book. That's how the parampara is supposed to be. So, in this way, here we find that Lord is apparently hiding. This hiding business Lord is doing is to increase the enthusiasm of Ramananda Rai. Just like, for example, somebody may show you a son babdi from Giriraj, and they may hide it. You may ask, Prabhu, where is that sweet you are holding? Oh, I don't know where I kept it. You may say that. Finally, you may give it to them. Huh? So Mahaprabhu is just increasing the hunger and thirst of Ramananda Rai, and then he is going to reveal to him. How will he hide him? He can't hide because Mahaprabhu loves Ramananda Rai, and he is convinced about Ramananda Rai's spiritual maturity and Ramananda Rai's beautiful presentation of the Krishna Tattva, Radha Tattva, everything. Mahaprabhu is going to reveal himself. Therefore, he is saying, why are you hiding yourself, my Lord? And then he is saying, Tabe Hasi Tare Prabhu Dekhaila Swarupa Rasa Raja Mahabhava Duhi Eka Rupa. See, Mahabhava Rupa is Radharani. Rasaraja Rupa is Krishna. So, Krishna is called Rasika Shekhar or Rasaraj. He is called as the object of love or the reservoir of pleasure. Rasaraj, king of rasa, reservoir of pleasure. Or he is called as the object of pleasure. Object of love. Radharani is called abode of love. Mahabhava. Mahabhava Swarupini Radha Takurani. She is abode of love. He is abode of rasa. And Dui Ekarupa. They both are one. They have become one in Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Yeah. Lord Sri Krishna is the reservoir of all pleasure. And Jamit Radharani is the personification of ecstatic love. Of Godhead. These two forms are combined as one in Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. This being the case, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu revealed his real form to Ramananda Rai. Then Prabhupada quoted that Swarupa Damodar's famous verse. Dekhi Ramananda Haila Anande Murchite Dharite na pare deha padila bhumite.
Yeah. Upon seeing this form, Ramananda Rai lost consciousness in transcendental bliss. Unable to remain standing, he fell to the ground.
Yeah. Actually, our body in this world cannot take the Sandrananda Visheshatma type of, you know, intense bliss. This body cannot take, this material body. We are knocked down. We may fall unconscious when we are overflooded by spiritual bliss. Of course, falling unconscious is one of the symptoms of ecstasy itself. One may shed tears, one's hair may stand on end, one's body may tremble, one's bodily color will change, and one may fall unconscious. And in that also there are various levels. Like Lord Chaitanya had fallen unconscious in front of Jagannath. And then Swarupa Bhattacharya had taken him to his house. So these are all symptoms of ecstatic bliss. Prabhu Tare Hasta Sparshi Karaila Chaitana Sanyasira Veshe Deki Vismita Hailamana.
When Ramananda Rai fell to the ground unconscious, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu touched his hand and he immediately regains consciousness. But when he saw Lord Chaitanya in the dress of the sannyasi, he was struck with the wonder.
Alingana Kari Prabhu Kaila Aswasana Toma Vinaye Irupa Nadeke Anyajana.
After embracing Ramananda Rai, the Lord pacified him, informed him, but for you, no one can even see this form.
Never seen this form, yeah. In this way, which means you see, these are all confidential exchanges between the Lord and the devotees. Like you all may be aware, there was one Brahmana, who was a traveling Brahmana, very pure soul, Vaishnava devotee. He came to the house of Jagannath Mishra and stayed overnight. And he wouldn't eat from the hand of anybody. He would personally cook for the Lord, offer it to his Balagopal. And then he will accept only the prasadam. That was his practice. He will only accept uncooked rice from others. So he also did the same thing with Jagannath Mishra's house. Accepted uncooked rice. But then when he cooked and he wanted to offer to Balagopal, he bowed down. While he was offering to Balagopal, the small child in Imai came there and he picked up and put a palmful of food in his mouth. So immediately he shouted, "Hi, hi!" He got very disturbed. This is actually cooked for the Lord and this child has by mistake eaten. So second time he cooked, second time the same thing happened again. Now he decided not to cook. The Jagannath Mishra came and begged and said, "Don't worry, you know, we will make sure that the child is kept by the ladies there. They will take care and we will bolt the door. He will not come here. You go ahead. Please kindly cook and everything." So he cooked again. But then, you know, Nimai Pandit is the Supreme Lord. What can he not do? He again came and put the hand and put palmful and eat. This time Brahmana cried out and said, "I am not going to cook at all. I think the Lord doesn't want me to eat today." But then Vishwarup came and pleaded. And Vishwarup was very handsome. And seeing his sober behavior and beauty, this Brahmana's heart was charmed. Otherwise, he would not have agreed at all. So finally, he agreed to cook. So when he cooked, it was more than midnight. Later than midnight. Everybody had slept away. Again, the small baby Nimai came. He smiled and he put the palmful in his mouth. And the Brahmana shouted, "Hi, hi!" And Nimai Pandit spoke to him now. "Hey, Brahmana, stop. Wait a minute. Why are you shouting like this? First of all, you ring the bell and call me. Therefore, I come. You are begging me to eat the food, so I am eating. And when I am eating, you are shouting. What is this? It doesn't make sense." So he said, and then Ban was surprised. And then he showed the Gopal form with a beautiful peacock feather and bluish complexion, playing on his flute as a Balagopal. When he showed the form, the Brahmana fainted unconscious. He had tears springing from his eyes and hair stood on end. His body was trembling. "Oh, this child is none other than Gopal." But then Nimai again resumed his form and said, "Hey, Brahmana, this darshan nobody else has got. Only to you I have given this. Because you are my pure devotee, you aspired to see me and serve me. I showed this darshan to you. But you should promise me that you will not tell anybody." And the Brahmana promised. And then Nimai vanished from there. But then the Brahmana ate that prasad, remnants left behind by Nimai. And he was trembling in ecstasy. He started chanting the holy names loudly. Govindo jaya jaya Gopala jaya jaya Radha Ramana Hari Govinda jaya jaya. So, and he started taking the rice and putting all over his body. And, you know, he was like brushing the body with the rice all over. So, people hearing his ecstatic kirtan and rolling on the ground with tears in the eyes, everybody came from the home, they got up. They asked, "Brahmana, what happened to you?" And Brahmana couldn't tell them also what happened. He said, "Oh, nothing, nothing, nothing." He felt shy. He could not tell them. So sometimes the Lord reveals to a pure devotee and says, "Don't tell anybody about this." There, Lord Nimai did like that. And here also, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is telling, "But for you, no one has ever seen this form of Radha and Krishna that I have shown you. So keep it with you. It's only for you. I don't generally reveal to everybody and anybody. If anybody calls me as Krishna or Vishnu, what I will do? I'll plug my ears and say, 'Vishnu, Vishnu, Vishnu.'" Because a person should not call a jiva as God. It is an offense. But why did Mahaprabhu do that? In order to teach all of us that nobody should try to deride the Supreme Lord and accept his position ruthlessly, foolishly, ignorantly. Therefore, Mahaprabhu did not want to present himself as an incarnation. Because he saw in Kali Yuga a lot of bogus incarnations will come. So he thought that if I declare my supremacy as Krishna, then others will also imitate and they may claim to be Krishna also. So Mahaprabhu played low-key. But confidentially he has revealed his identity to people like Ramananda Rai, Advaita Acharya Prabhu, Sarvabhattacharya, From these pastimes, you can understand who Mahaprabhu is. Plus, from the Shastras and from the great souls like Swarup Damodar and Jiva Goswami, Rupa Goswami, from the great Acharyas, from the scriptures, and from the revelations that he did to some of the great souls. So we can understand his supremacy. Therefore, the purpose is Naham Prakasha Sarvasya Yoga Maya Samavrata. Lord is not easily manifest to the foolish and unintelligent. So Prabhupada says in one of the purports in Kunti 1.8.36, in there he says that, you know, Karna, Duryodhana, Dushasana, they all saw Krishna eye to eye. But they could not appreciate Krishna's position. They could not appreciate Krishna's love for all of us. They actually saw him, and that's what is happening in the modern times also. Many so-called educated people who are very proud of their mundane education, they are reading the scriptures, but they are not able to decode anything. They are not able to benefit themselves or benefit others, because they approach the Vedic literature from a very, what do you call it, scholarly point of view. So therefore then they will remain ignorant. For example, somebody came to our temple and said, she has written some songs, you know, similar to Mirabai songs, following in the footsteps of Mira's writings. And she wants to present these songs on the stage and publish the book from our temple. And then we found that she is not chanting the holy name. She is not studying the philosophy. And there are many people like this who actually take writing poetry or writing a novel or even writing commentary to Gita as a hobby, without living it, without practicing it, without giving their heart to it. So that will not do. Therefore, Lord also doesn't reveal himself to such people, to mundane scholars and, you know. See, Prabhupada says here, you can read this one. Yeah, this one you can read.
Gradually, the sincere devotee pleases the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Gradually, the sincere devotee pleases the Supreme Personality of Godhead and the Supreme Lord reveals himself. One cannot see the Supreme Lord by making personal efforts. Rather, when the Lord is pleased by the service of a devotee, he reveals himself.
Yeah. This one word, pleasing a person. It's a very stout word and a very big word. Because in the path of bhakti, the end result to be achieved is the person should be pleased whom we are trying to serve. Say the Guru or Krishna, that person should be pleased. Somebody may say, you know, I did this, I did that, so many things. I did. Okay, you did, but what was the result of that? Whether that person was pleased, that you have to ask. Because if that person is not pleased, all our efforts are like pouring ghee in ashes. Is it not true? So that end result is samsiddhir haritoshanam. Yeah. Varnarashram acharavat purushena parappuman vishnu raradi tappanta nanyat tat tosha karanam. Tat tosha karanam. Vishnu's tosh or samsiddhir haritoshanam. That should be seen. And Lord is pleased. So how the Lord will be pleased? There is one verse in the Bhagavatam. Dayaya sarva bhuteshu santushtya yena kenava sarvendriyo pashantyacha tushyatyashu janardana. This verse says that dayaya sarva bhuteshu, be compassionate to all other creatures. Santushtya yena kenava, whatever comes of its own accord, be satisfied. Don't be greedy. And sarvendriyo pashantyacha, keep all your senses peaceful and calm without hankering for anything mundane. And the Lord Hari is pleased. So this is one verse. Like that, there are many verses which talk about, like if you go to the 12th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, verse number 12 to 20, Krishna says, who are the devotees very dear to him? Like he says, Harsha Amarsha Bayodbegir Mukto Yasacha Me Priya, Me Priya. Like that he will repeatedly say, Advesta Sarvabhutana Maitra Karuna Yevaja Nirmamo Nirahankara Samadukka Sukakshami Santrushta Satatam Yogi Yatatma Dhanishayaha Mayi Arpita Mano Buddhir Yomad Bhakta Same Priyaha. And then Yasmano Udvijite Loko Lokano Udvijite Chayaha Harsha Amarsha Bayodbegir Mukto Yachachme Priyaha समशत्रौ च मित्रे च तदा मानापमानयो शीतोष्ण सुख दुःखेषु समसङ्गविवर्जितः तुल्यनिन्दासुतिर्मौनैः सन्तुष्टो येन केनचित् अनिकेतस्तरमतिर्भक्तिमान्मे प्रियो नरः. सो इन् दिस् वे अण्ड् देन् फैनलि हि विल् से ये तु धर्मामृतमिदं यथोक्तं पर्युपासते श्रद्धदानामत्परमा भक्तास्ते अतीव मे प्रियाः, वेरि डियर् टु मी सच् अ डिवोटि. सो इन् दिस् वे सो यु केन् लर्न् ओ कृष्ण सेस् दीस् आर् द थिङ्ग्स् विच् प्लीज़् हिम् 12-20 those verses. Anapekshishchitraksha udasyeno kadavyadaha sarvarambha parityagi omad bhakta same priya aniketa. So all these words can be collected. What all Krishna says pleases him in the life of a devotee, and we can make an effort to do those things and please him. So when the Lord is pleased, when the devotee is pleased, then the Lord will reveal himself. That's the secret. There's one more verse, revelation verse, that Kunti is speaking. Tata paramahamsanam muninam amalatmanam bhakti yoga vidhanartham katam pashye mahistriyah. I am a simple woman, my Lord. How can I access you? You are only accessible to the great souls whose heart is completely rendered pure. And those who are paramahamsas, those who are like a hansa pakshi, hansa which only takes the milk and leaves the water, those people who don't care for the material situations, who always look for your dust of your lotus feet everywhere. So they are all pure souls. For them you are visible and accessible, not for insignificant devotee like me. Like that she is telling Kunti, correct? No, another place she is saying, namo akinchana vittaya nivritta guna vrittaye. My Lord, you are only accessible to those who translate the three gunas, sattva, rajas, tamas, nivritta guna vritti. And you are also visible to them who are namo akinchana vittaya. They don't have any material commodities. They only have you as their possession. For them you are visible. You are everything for them. Then you are visible. And then she is telling, for who else is visible? Shrinvanti gayanti krinanti abhikshashah smaranti nandanti tavehitam dana janaha tayeva pashyanti acharena tavakam bhava prabahu uparamam padambujam. There also again pashya word is coming. What is that verse? He says, those who are constantly hearing about you, they are glorifying you, they are chanting your holy name, abhikshashah, continuously. And they are remembering you, and they are making others remember you. Smaranti smarayanti cha, it is said. They are making others remember you. And those people will easily cross over samsara and see your lotus feet. She is saying. So in this way Kunti Maharani says, and then she is saying, janma aishwarya shruta shibir yedamana madapuman naivarhatya vidatum vaitvam akinchana gocharam. She is saying, those who are proud of their high birth or high education or wealth or bodily beauty, they cannot feelingly call your name. Therefore, they cannot feelingly see your lotus feet. So we get a lot of clue from Kunti Maharani, who can see Krishna and who cannot see Krishna. So the right attitude is required in approaching the Lord if you really want to have his darshan. We have to actually pray to him for his darshan by having rendered service to him. Like for example, Jagannath Swami Nayana Patagami Bhava Tumi. It's a prayer actually. Oh Lord Jagannath, Nayana Patagami, you please give me the eyes to see you. I have no ability to see you. I am blind. I am blind. I am ignorant. I am foolish. I have no Shakti. I have no Buddhi to see you, to access you. So, if that type of attitude is there, then the Lord reveals himself. So, here comes a very important point. Awareness and admittance of one's lacking in surrender, lacking in Vaishnava qualities. First, we should be aware that I am lacking in these things, and we should go to the Lord and admit. These two steps are there. Many people are not even aware that they lack Vaishnava qualities. And even if they become aware, they will keep it secret. They may not want to admit in front of the Lord. Therefore, you find songs like this. Gauranga karuna karav dinahina jane mosama patita prabhu Nahi Tribhuvane. See, here he's singing, in the three worlds you will not find a fallen soul like me, he's saying. So, therefore I'm begging you, please Karana Karo, Gauranga, he's saying. And then he's saying, Patita Pavana. No, what's the next line? Mosama Patita Prabhu. Nahi Tribhuvane. Dante Trina Dhuri Gaura. Daki he tomar. Kripa Kori Soyamar. Hridaya Mandire. Yadi Dayana Koribe. Patita Dekiya. Patita Pavana Nama. Kisara Lagiya. He's saying, my dear Lord, your name is Patita Pavan and I am the best Patita in the entire three worlds. So we are a good match. I am Patita and you are Patita Pavan. How wonderful it is. Why didn't you come and deliver me? Then what's the use of your name Patita Pavan if you don't deliver Patitas like me? So this is one song. Like this, many Acharyas have fervently offered prayers from their heart, presenting and declaring their own fallen position, although they were not fallen. Portraying the role of a conditioned soul like us, they have begged at the Lord's lotus feet, considering themselves fallen. And they have also praised the Lord's qualities requested the Lord for darshan, for surrender, for service at the Lord's lotus feet. And seeing their quality of their consciousness, the Lord revealed Himself to them and Lord accepted them. So therefore, entering kingdom of God is a question of humility. Humility actually means admitting one's deficiency in the necessary Vaishnava qualities to attract the Lord. And also it is a question of freedom from presenting one's qualifications, or it's a freedom from false pride. And also another way to qualify to see the Lord is to peacefully render service to Him. Therefore it is said, do not try to see the Lord. Try to serve Him in such a way that the Lord will want to see you. So I heard one pastime of one devotee, Vibhu Chaitanya Prabhu from Vrindavan. It was so heart-rending how he served Krishna Balaram. So several years he was a pujari since Prabhupada's times. So he would be doing so much hard work, service. Prabhupada was very pleased with him, day and night. And Prabhupada would glorify the devotee also. Then after Prabhupada left the world, planet, back to Godhead, he continued to serve there. He became very old. Devotees even now say that he can do the service of six pujaris put together, six in one. That much capability he had. He would cook also, he would wash the plates also, he would dress the deities also. He would offer the bhog and then bring the plate out. Everything he will do. Single-handedly for all the deities he can do. He was having tremendous capacity like that. And then when he got old, 75, 80, 85, his body was becoming very weak. He could not do all the services. Then he would request some devotees to come and help, and then gradually many other pujaris took up. But he didn't want to give up the service. And he would continue rendering cooking service, sitting in a chair, be cooking. Later on, his body became very bent. He could not properly lift the things and all. His hand was shivering. So still he wanted to serve. So he came out of the deity room and he would sit in one spot and give charanamrita to the devotees. Whichever devotee would come, his hand would be shaking and he would give charanamrita to them. He's sitting in one place. Still his last breath, he was serving. So here is an example of a devotee cheerfully serving without any anticipation. So therefore, Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Thakur said, serve the Lord in such a way that He will want to come and see you. So these devotees are actually seeing the Lord already in their lives. If they are not seeing the Lord, how are they so joyful in Krishna consciousness? How are they so fixed up in their path of bhakti? Satatam kirtayan tomam yatantascha jadabrata. With great determination. So here also, Ramanand Rai is requesting the Lord to give His darshan. मोर तत्व लीला रस तुम्हारा गोचरे,
मोर तत्व लीला रस तुम्हारा
अतएव यही रूप देखाय लो तुम्हारे या
श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु कन्फर्म्ड ऑल द ट्रूथ्स अबाउट माई पास टाइम्स एंड मेलोज आर विद इन योर नॉलेज देयरफॉर आई हैव शोन दिस फॉर्म टू यू
या हे रामानंदराय व्हाट इज देयर दैट यू डू नॉट नो यू नो एवरीथिंग प्रैक्टिकली रामानंदराय सो नोबडी कैन हाइड फ्रॉम यू सो एक्चुअली लॉर्ड चैतन्य हैड अ डीप अप्रिसिएशन फॉर रामानंदराय यू नो विजडम एंड रियलाइजेशन अबाउट राधा कृष्ण तत्व गौरांग नहि मोर राधांग स्पर्शन गोपेन्द्र सुत विनाते हो ना स्पर्श अन्य जन
एक्चुअली माई बॉडी डज नॉट हैव अ फेयर कॉम्प्लेक्शन इट ओनली अपियर्स सो बिकॉज इट हैज टच्ड द बॉडी ऑफ श्रीमती राधारानी हाउ एवर शी डज नॉट टच एनी वन बट द सन ऑफ नंद महाराज
Radharani has covered the body of Shyam Sundar to protect him from falling on the ground and hurting himself. She told him, if you want to be Bhakta, I am worried, she said. Because, you know, we are all Bhaktas, we know, in transcendental ecstasy, we jump and we may fall, we may roll on the ground. Oh, I don't want to see you hurt, Shyam Sundar. So she enveloped his body with her color, with her golden complexion.
तार भावे भावित करी आत्ममना
तबे निज माधुर्य करी आस्वादना
I have now converted my body and mind into the ecstasy of Srimati Radharani. Thus, I am tasting my own personal sweetness in that form.
Mahaprabhu now revealed to him. This is the truth.
তোমার ঠাই আমার কিছু গুপ্ত নাহি কর্ম লুকাইলে প্রেম বলে জান সর্বমর্ম লর্ড চৈতন্য মহাপ্রভু দেন অ্যাডমিটেড টু হিজ পিওর ডিভোটি রামানন্দ রায় নাও দেয়ার ইজ নো কনফিডেন্সিয়াল অ্যাক্টিভিটি আননোন টু ইউ ইভেন দো আই ট্রাই টু কনসিল মাই অ্যাক্টিভিটিজ ইউ ক্যান আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড এভরিথিং ইন ডিটেল by virtue of your advanced love for me.
In this way, I told you yesterday that point that Lord is mystical to the jnanis and yogis and karmis, but the Lord is merciful to the devotees. So what is the meaning of that? Merciful to the devotees means He will reveal Himself to the devotee. Actually, Lord reveals Himself also, and He also reveals very, very powerful confidential truths too. The devotees. Like Vishwanatha Chakravarti Thakur's commentary, if you read about the Jai Vijay and Four Kumaras interaction in the spiritual world door, Vaikuntha door, you will realize that, my Lord, what a deep realization Chakravarti Thakur has brought. Actually, for each of those shlokas, you know, why the particular word is used in the Bhagavatam, you will be amazed. That kind of deep realization of the Lord's heart. Therefore, dharma, there is a verse, no? Dharmasya Tattvam. Nihitam guhayam, mahajano yena katha sappanta. So mahajanas, if you want to really find out the truth about Krishna, about everything in spiritual life, it is residing in the heart of a pure Vaishnava. Yeah. What is that verse? Dharmasya tattvam nihitam guhayam, mahajano yena katha sappanta. Dharmam tu sakshat bhagavat pranitam, na vai vidu, rishayo napi deva, na siddha mukhya, Asura manushya kuton vidyadara charanadeha. And then he says, this one, Swayambhu narada shambhu kumara kapilo manu pralatu janako vishma balirvayasa kirvayam dvadashi yete vijani mo dharman bhagavatan bataha guhyam vishuddham durbodham yadnyatva amrtam ashnute. There also he says, guhyam vishuddham durbodham. Guhyam means it's paramarahasyam. Vishuddham, it's on the transcendental platform. Durbodham, even learned scholars cannot have access to it. Yad jnatva amrita mashnute, by knowing which one can attain the immortal spiritual world. And where is that guhyam available? He says, tarko apratishta shrutiyo abhinna, nasa vrishir yasya matam na bhinnam, dharmasya tattvam nihitam guhayam, mahajano yena katha sappantha. He says, tarko apratishta shrutiyo abhinna. Many, many rishis, munis are saying so many different things. We don't know who is right, who is wrong. And Shastras are oceanic. and the meanings of the Vedas are very deep, and our life is very short, time is very precious. So how are we going to know the truth? Here is the solution. Dharmasya tattvam nihitam guhayam. The good tattva is in the heart of a pure Vaishnava like Ramananda Rai or His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. Okay, then how do you enter into their hearts? You can enter their hearts by studying their commentaries. Because they have put it down for us. They have poured it out from their heart. So by reading their purports and commentaries and contemplating on what they are saying, slowly the truth will become revealed to us. For we are all actually in that mood of Prabhupada Anuga or Rupa Anuga. We say Anuga means follower. Become a faithful follower. Then the acharyas will reveal the truth to us. Then life becomes very easy for us. And we don't have to speculate. We don't have to run around here and there how to get the truth. And we don't have to jump like a fox to get the grapes. And the fox could never get the grapes. It only called the grapes sour. Similarly, we may try to capture Krishna, capture the truth, and then finally end up becoming an impersonalist if we endeavor on our own. But if we accept this path of Dharma Satyatvam Nihitam Guhayam, even Sridhara Swami has given a beautiful definition of bhakti, Shuddha Bhakti. Iti rahasyatvat swamukhenaiva bhagavata anjasa avidushamapi pumsam atmalabdhaye. This is the definition he gives. He is saying, iti rahasyatvat, the path of bhakti yoga where Krishna will be revealed to you. It's a very great parama rahasyam. As Krishna says, no, yetad rahasyam yetad uttamam. He says, no, bhaktosi me sakacheti rahasyam yetad uttamam. That is bhakti. He is saying, iti rahasyatvat swa mukhe naiva bhagavata. This Shuddha Bhakti knowledge is given by Krishna himself to Uddhava. Yeah, he gives it. So in Bhagavad Gita also, Bhagavatam also, Lord Krishna gives. Swa mukhe naiva bhagavata. From his own mouth, Lord speaks it for the welfare of the devotees. And then avidushama pumsam atmalabdhaye. Even a person who is a fool, you know, if he simply hears from an acharya and faithfully follows, he can become enlightened like the South Indian Brahmin. Correct, no? And then he is saying, anjasa, very easily. Atmalabdhaye, one can attain this truth. So Ramananda Rai got darshan very easily by simply pleasing Lord Chaitanya. Can you give some examples of somebody who pleased somebody and got darshan? Like Devahuti pleased Kardama Muni and got the darshan of Vaikuntha, planets. You know, he gave her a darshan. And Brahmaji pleased Lord Vishnu, who gave his own darshan, shook hands with him, and Lord revealed Vaikuntha also to him, to Brahma also. Similarly, Vijayabhasa is pleased to Krishna. And Krishna also pleased, I mean, Krishna also revealed Goloka to them. Also, yeah. Once Narottama Thakur was a prince, king's son, but he wanted to take Diksha from Lokanath Goswami, who would not give at all. He had made up his mind not to give to anybody. He was very, very humble Vaishnava. He was a lover of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Lokanath Goswami. He wouldn't talk to anybody. He would just chant the holy name and play a very low key. There are some Vaishnavas like that who gave valuable information to Krishnas Kaviraj Goswami under one condition. Lokanath Goswami and Gopalapada Goswami told Kaviraj Goswami, we'll give you a lot of information about Mahaprabhu, but with one condition, that our name should not be published. You should not glorify us. So what he did, they were not glorified in CC, but they were glorified in another place, another book. Another place. From that's how we got information from there, isn't it? So in this way, Lokanath Goswami thought that me becoming guru, no, I am unqualified utterly. So then Narottama Das understood that the guru is not pleased with me. So let me serve him now. So guru used to go for doing the morning duties in one place in the forest in a bush. So he went behind the bush after the guru would finish his business and push off. So he would clean that place with a broomstick and put sand. And next day guru would go there, it would be completely clean. Wondering who has done this. He was most amazed. And one of the days he found out Narottam is doing it. Narottam, you are a prince. How can I do such kind of activities like this? And Narottam cried and said, Guru, I have no other hope. You know, unless you accept me, unless you accept my service, you know, I cannot be delivered. And he fell at his feet and cried, accept me as your disciple. And he accepted him. He is the only disciple of Lokanath Goswami. So by service, he pleased Guru. Similarly, you'll find Hanuman. Hanuman is a disciple of Suryadeva. Suryadev said, you see, so I'm sorry, I can't accept you as a disciple. I'm traveling all around. You know, every day I have to keep on moving. Where will I get time to sit with you and teach you? He said, Guruji, you don't worry about that. I will travel with you. I will walk backwards, you walk frontwards. So Hanuman was walking back like this. And then Suryadev went on giving Atmabodh, preaching to him. And after that, Hanuman asked, now what can be the Guru Dakshina I can give you? So he made one request, Surya. He said, you know, my descendant is Sugriva, but he's not very intelligent. He has some problems, defects, deficiencies. I will request you to go and support him, guide him, support him, be with him, and never leave him, even in his foul weather also. Because generally in this world we find fair weather friends, but you have to be with him even in foul weather. If you do that, I'll be very pleased, Guru told him. So when Hanuman came down, he joined hands with Sugriva when Sugriva had lost his kingdom. Sugriva actually was hiding in the Rishimukha Parvatas, mountains, because of fear of Vali. Yeah. So that time Hanuman was with him. He was penniless beggar. Actually, he was a king for a while, but then Vali came and bet him and drove him out, correct, no? Then he was actually, but Hanuman supported him. Even though Sugriva committed many mistakes, Hanuman didn't leave him. Why? Because Guru had told him. So he faithfully followed the Guru's words. So this is another way, by pleasing the Guru, by making enormous endeavor to please him, then one pleases Krishna and then Krishna gives darshan. So I told you many routes today, elaborately. Therefore I wanted to elaborate on this. Yesterday there was no time. I was elaborating on this. Today what all I said, dharmasya tattvam, the entire truth of the scriptures is residing in the heart of a pure devotee who is faithfully, sincerely practicing Krishna consciousness. We have to go and glue on with such a devotee and beg the devotee to give the association. Like Ramandra is one such devotee. Yeah, there are many Mahatma devotees in this world. And Prabhupada was one such Mahatma when he went to the West. And many people who connected with him strongly, they became similar Mahatmas themselves also. So that was one thing I elaborately spoke now. And second thing I also said about pleasing Guru. By pleasing Guru, then Krishna is pleased. And also, one should also know what all will please Krishna. So I told you a few verses. Daya sarva bhuteshu santushtaya yanakenava. And then the 12th chapter, 12 to 20. So in this way, Krishna clearly says, these are the things that will please me. I'm a Baba Grahi Janardhan, correct, no? You can't trick me, you can't cheat me, you can't be duplicitous to me. You can't, you know, have something in the heart and something outside. You know, I'll figure it out, I'll find out easily. I am Antaryami, Super Soul in everybody's heart. So you have to become thoroughly honest with Krishna. So in this way, there are various ways to know how to please Krishna and Guru. And by pleasing them like that, you know, then the Lord will not hide himself anymore. Then Lord is unable to hide. He reveals himself.
Gupte rakiha kaha na kariyo prakasha. Amara batula cheshta loke upahasa.
Yeah.
The Lord then requested Ramananda Rai, keep all these talks a secret. Please do not expose them anywhere and everywhere. Since my activities appear to be like those of a madman, people may take them lightly and laugh.
Ami ek batula tumi dvitiya batula.
Ami ek batula tumi dvitiya batula.
Atayeva tamaya maya hai samatula.
Yeah. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu then said, indeed I am a madman and you are also a madman. Therefore we are on the same platform.
Yeah, I'll show you one shloka from Bhagavatam, just 1 minute. Yeah. This is the verse. Yeah, correct. This is the verse. This is 3:7:17. We'll recite it. Yascha mooda tamo loke. Yascha buddhe param gataha. Tavubhau sukham edete. Krishyantyan tarita janaha. I read the translation.
Both the lowest of fools and he who is transcendental to all intelligence enjoy happiness, whereas persons between them suffer the material pangs.
He's saying two people enjoy happiness. One is the lowest of the fool and the person who is transcendental. So Mahaprabhu and Ramandra are in the transcendental category. Correct, no? And the other fools who appear to be enjoying, but they are mentally retarded fellows. Huh? Then read the purport.
The lowest of fools do not understand material miseries. They pass their lives merrily and do not inquire into the miseries of life.
And so, how are they able to pass merrily? Because they are in tamoguna or rajoguna. In tamoguna or rajoguna, the activities what they are doing, they can't see it as suffering. Who can see it that they are suffering? One in sattoguna can see. Like a person who is smoking, he is sucking through the mouth and leaving the smoke through the nose. Like an engine, like a train engine. Train goes na, like that he's leaving. And he's thinking it's wonderful. And if a doctor is looking at him, you'll think, my Lord, he is making his lungs charred completely like carbon black. And he's leaving through the nose, he's hurting himself. But the fool cannot see. Correct, no?
Yeah.
Yes?
Such persons are almost on the level of animals, who although in the eyes of superiors are always miserable in life, are unaware of material distresses. A hog's life is degraded in its standard of happiness, which entails living in a filthy place, engaging in sex enjoyment at every opportune moment, and laboring hard in a struggle for existence. But this is unknown to the hog. Similarly, human beings who are unaware of the miseries of material existence and are happy in sex life and hard labor are the lowest of fools. Yet because they have no sense of miseries, they supposedly enjoy so-called happiness. The other class of men, those who are liberated and are situated in the transcendental position above intelligence, are really happy and are called Paramhamsas. But persons who are neither like hogs and dogs nor on the level of Paramhamsas feel the material pangs, and for them, inquiry about the Supreme Truth is necessary. The Vedanta Sutras...
So, correct, no? He has written about both Paramhamsas and the fools. It's a very beautiful verse. Yascha mooda tamo loke. Yascha buddhe param gataha. Yeah. Tavu bahu sukam edete. Krishyanti antarito jana. What happened? How to... This one? I had already... I opened it in another one. This one. And this one I think I had to... Yeah. Correct. So, he said, Ami Bhatula, Tumi Bhatula, he is saying, I am madman, you are a madman, because both are transcendental. They are talking very lofty and very fine subject. And it became revealed when the Brahmanas who came with Ramanand Rai were bewildered. Correct, no? When Ramanand Rai and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu were embracing and crying, those Brahmanas were all bewildered, those smartha Brahmanas. So, that is the proof that these two men are transcendental, and those who are not transcendental were getting bewildered, confused. That's what Mahaprabhu said, the common people cannot understand these things, Samantra, so don't tell this to others. Yeah, like that he's saying. Yairupa dasharatri Ramananda Sange Suke Gavaila Prabhu Krishna Katarange. Yeah.
For 10 nights, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Ramananda Rai spent a happy time discussing the pastimes of Krishna.
Niguda Prajera Rasa Lila Ravichara Aneka Kahila Tara Napaila Para. Yeah.
The conversations between Ramananda Rai and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu contain the most confidential subject matters, touching the conjugal love between Radha and Krishna in Vrindavan, Vrajabhumi. Although they talked at great length about these pastimes, they could not reach the limit of discussion.
तमा कांसा रूप सोना रत्न चिंतामणि केह यदि कहां पोता पाय एक खानी।
Actually, these conversations are like a great mine where from a single place one can extract all kinds of metals, copper, bell metal, silver and gold, and also touchstone, the basis of all metals.
Yeah, so this I already told you, you know, in the previous conversations. Yeah, we had the table. So I told you that this is Swadharma Acharana is copper. This is verse number 57, 58, in this chapter. Each chapter is Swadharma Acharana is copper, Krishna Karma Arpana is bell metal, Swadharma Tyaga is silver, and Jnana Mishra Bhakti is gold, and Jnana Shunya Bhakti is touchstone. Again, when you come to Prema Bhakti, again one more gradation. When you just take only Prema Bhakti, it is copper. Then you can go higher in that. For example, if you go, you know, in Prema, in Dasya Prem, it is bell metal. Sakya Prem, it is silver. And then Vatsalya Prem, gold. And Kanta Prem, touchstone. Those five. So there are two levels of gradation. One is the Swadharma Acharana and all that, and then once you go to Prema Bhakti, then there are five gradations. So in this way, it's like two miners, you know, miner. Those are taking, generally when you go to one mountain where you get gold, you dig only, get gold only, but here you get multiple metals. Like that they discussed and brought out like miners. Amazing. Yeah. Read this, Sabakshanji Thakur.
Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Thakur points out that in Vrajabhumi, there is Yamuna river with its sandy banks. There are Kadamba trees, cows, Krishna's sticks with which he herds crows, and Krishna's flute. All of these belong to Shantaras, the mellow of neutrality in devotional service. There are also the direct servants of Krishna, such as Chitraka, Patraka and Raktaka, and these are the embodiments of service in the mellow of servitude. There are also friends like Sridhama and Sudama, who embody service in fraternity. Nanda Maharaj and Mother Yashoda are the embodiments of parental love. Above all of these are Srimati Radharani and her assistants, the gopis, Lalita, Vishakha and others, who embody conjugal love. In this way, all five mellows, Shanta, Dasya, Sakya, Vatsalya and Madhurya, exist eternally in Vrajabhumi. They are also compared respectively to copper, bell metal, silver, gold and touchstone, the basis of all metals. Srila Kaviraj Goswami therefore refers to a mine eternally existing in Vrindavan, Vrajabhumi.
See, touchstone, gold, silver, they are all very high quality, you know that. And then there is also bell metal and copper also, below that, yeah. Krame uthayite seha uttama vastu paya aiche prashnotara kaila prabhu ramaraya. Yeah.
Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Ramananda Rai worked like miners, excavating all kinds of valuable metals, each one better than the other. Their questions and answers are exactly like that.
Aradina Raya Pashe Vidaya Magila Vidaya Kalitare Agnadila.
The next day, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu begged Ramananda Rai to give him permission to leave, and at the time of farewell, the Lord gave him the following orders.
Vishaya chadiya tumi yaha nila chale Aami tirtha karitaha asiva alpakale.
Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told him, give up all material engagements and come to Jagannath Puri. I will return there very soon after finishing my tour and pilgrimage.
Mahaprabhu said, you give up your job and go to Puri. I will finish my Tirthyatra and come back, and we both will have a good time in Puri. Now we could only discuss shortly. We can discuss even more when you come there. Good plan. Dui jane nila chale rahi bhaye ka sange. Sukhe gawai bakala Krishna katha range.
The two of us shall remain together at Jagannath Puri and happily pass our time discussing Krishna.
Yes, this is ultimate goal. Tannama rupa charitadi sukirtanana srutyo krameena rasana manasi niyojya tishthan vraje tadanuragi jananugami kalam nayet akilamityupadesha saram. The saram of all upadeshas, kalam nayet, spend your time. How? Tannama rupa charitadi sukirtanana. You should hear and glorify Krishna's name, form, qualities, pastimes and activities. Smrityo, you remember them. Krameena manasan, rasana manasi, rasana is tongue. Engage the tongue in glorifying. And manasa means meditating. Niyojya, tishthan praje, stay in Vrindavan. Tad anuragi jana anugami, become anugami of anuragi jan. Kalam nayed. That's what Mahaprabhu is saying. Come there, Jagannath Puri, both will spend time there, he's saying. Yetabali Ramanande Kariyalingana Tare Gare Pathaya Karila Shayana. Yeah.
Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu then embraced Shri Ramananda Rai and after sending him back to his home, the Lord took rest.
Yeah.
Pratakale Uti Prabhu Deki Hanuman. Tare Namaskari Prabhu Dakshine Karila Prayan.
Yeah.
After rising from bed the next morning, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu visited the local temple where there was the deity of Hanuman. After offering him obeisances, the Lord departed for South India.
By saying that in India, everywhere there are cities and towns, Hanuman temple is there, eternal servant of Lord Rama. There is even a temple of Hanumanji near the Govindji temple in Vrindavan. In this way, Prabhupada is saying about that. Hanumanji has been respectfully worshipped for many hundreds and thousands of years. Even Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu set the example that one should offer respects to Hanumanji because of pure devotee of the Lord.
Vidyapure nana mata lokavaiseyata. Prabhu darshane Vaishnava haila chadi nijamata.
All the residents of Vidyanagar were of different faiths. But after seeing Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they abandoned their own faith and became Vaishnavas.
Amazing, na? Amazing. Ramananda Haila Prabhu Ravi Rahe Vihvala
Prabhu Radhyane Rahe Vishaya Chadiya Sakala.
When Ramananda Rai began to feel separation from Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he was overwhelmed. Meditating on the Lord, he gave up all his material business.
This is the method of giving up material life and taking the spiritual life seriously. Artificially, if somebody gives up material life, he will be finished. He will suffer. He will again go back to material life. Actually, while being in material life, one should meditate on spiritual life in the company of very seriously situated devotees. And by repeatedly meditating on them and their sincerity, seriousness, then we also get, you know, inspired to renounce the unwanted things of the world, anarthas, and surrender more and more. That's what Ramananda Rai did, Raghunath Das Goswami did that, Sanatana did that. All the great souls, you will see, they admired the devotees, they admired Mahaprabhu, constantly remembering they could do that.
Sankshepe kahilu Rama Anandera Milana Vistari Varanite Nare Sahasravadana.
Yeah.
I have briefly described the meeting between Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Ramananda Rai. No one can actually describe this meeting exhaustively. It is even impossible for the Lord Sheshanag, who has thousands of foods.
Yeah, I have only briefly described this saying.
Sahaja Chaitanya Charita Ghana Dugda Pura. Ramananda Charita Tahe Khanda Prachura.
Yeah.
The activities of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu are like condensed milk and the activities of Ramananda Rai are like large quantities of sugar candy.
Radha Krishna Leela Tate Karpuram Vilana Bhagyavan Yehi Sehi Kare Aswadana.
Yeah.
Their meeting is exactly like a mixture of condensed milk and sugar candy. When they talk of the pastimes of Radha and Krishna, camphor is added. One who tastes this combined preparation is most fortunate.
So what is Radha Krishna Leela? Camphor. And what is Ramananda Rai? Misri. Sugar candy. And what is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu? Condensed milk. Mix all the three. powerful. One is fortunate to get that vibration.
Yaiha ekabara piye karna dware. Tarakarna lobhe iha chadite na pare.
This wonderful preparation has to be taken
orally, orally through the ears.
Yeah. If one takes it, he becomes greedy to relish it even further.
Rasatattva jnana haya ihare shravane. Prema bhakti haya radha krishne racharane. Yeah.
By hearing the talks between Ramananda Raya and Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, one becomes enlightened with the transcendental knowledge of the mellows of Radha and Krishna's pastimes. Thus, one can develop unalloyed love for the lotus feet of Radha and Krishna.
We become enlightened by hearing their conversation, and then we get deep unalloyed love. Chaitanya raguda tattva janiha haite.
Chaitanya raguda tattva janiha.
Vishwasa karishuna tarka nakariha chite.
The author requests every reader to hear these talks with faith and without argument. By studying them in this way, one will be able to understand the confidential truth of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Yeah, very vital point is hear with faith and don't argue, because subject is very advanced. And don't put your ordinary brain, mundane brain is useless. You can't do anything. You will waste your time also by mundane arguments. So if you have faith in Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, put aside all your tarka, vitarka, kutarka, everything, and just pay peacefully here and chant the holy name and render devotional service, everything will be revealed. Yeah.
Alaukika lilayai paramaniguda. Vishwase paye tarka tarke haya bahudura.
Yeah.
This part of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's pastime is most confidential. One can derive benefit quickly only by faith. Otherwise, by arguing, one will always remain far away.
Sri Chaitanya Nityananda Advaita Charana Yahara Sarvasvatare Milaye Dhana.
He who has accepted as everything the lotus feet of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu and Advaita Prabhu can attain this transcendental treasure.
Yeah. The Bhaktisiddhanta Thakur says that Krishna is obtainable for the faithful, but for those who are accustomed to argue, Krishna is far, far away. Similarly, these talks between Ramananda and Chaitanya Mahaprabhu can be understood to be by a person who has firm faith. Ashrauta Pantis means they cannot have faith in these talks. They are always doubting and engaging in mental concoctions, he is saying. Okay. I am Atma Pravachanin, love you. Okay. So, Prabhupada is talking about this thing, arguers. And then whether one is a prakrasahaji or a mundane opportunist, a scholar, one's labor to understand these topics by mundane means will ultimately be frustrated. One therefore has to give up the mundane attempts and try to become a pure devotee. Atas Sri Krishna Amadi Prabhupada quotes that. Yeah. However, when the senses are purified, then only Radha Krishna pastime will be revealed. Therefore, patiently hear with faith and practice devotion service and don't argue, don't waste time.
Ramananda, Ramananda Raye Mora, Koti Namaskara. Yaramukhe Kaila Prabhu Rasera Vistara.
I offer 10 million obeisances unto the lotus feet of Sri Ramananda Raya because from his mouth such much spiritual information has been expanded by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Namodara Swarupera Kadacha Anusare Ramananda Milana Leela Karila Prachare.
Yeah.
I have tried to preach the pastimes of Lord Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Mahaprabhu's meeting with Ramananda Raya, in accordance with the notebooks of Sri Swarup Damodar.
Yeah, Prabhupada is appreciating how the author Kaviraj Goswami admits the value of disciplic succession. He never claims to have written the book by carrying out any research work. He simply admits his indebtedness to notes taken by Swarup Damodar and Raghunath Das Goswami and other authoritative persons. This is the way of writing transcendental literatures, which are never meant for so-called scholars and research workers. Mahajano yena katha sappanta, Prabhupada is quoting that. The prakrasahajas claim that they heard the truth from their guru, but one cannot have transcendental knowledge simply by hearing from a guru who is not bona fide. The guru must be bona fide, and he must have heard from the own bona fide guru, he is saying. And then he is quoting that Imamavasvati Yogam. Okay, last.
श्री रूप रघुनाथ पदे यार आशा,
श्री रूप रघुनाथ पदे
यार आशा, चैतन्य चरितामृत कहे कृष्ण दास। Praying at the lotus feet of Shri Rupa and Raghunath, I always desiring their mercy. I, Krishna Das, narrate Shri Chaitanya Charitamrita following in their footsteps. Thus ends the Bhaktivedanta purport Shri Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Lila, each chapter describing the talks between Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Ramananda Rai. Shri Ramananda Rai ki, Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu ki, Shri Chaitanya Charitamrita ki, Shri Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami ki, Shri Prabhupada ki, Gaur Bhaktavinda ki. Thank you very much. We've completed.